Good morning to all of you guys. Good morning to all of you. I hope you guys are perfectly fine. कैसे आप सब लोग? चलिए सब लोग आ जाइए. Today we are going to start a new chapter. So I want all of you guys to be live right now. जल्दी से सब लोग आ जाइए. चलिए एवरीबडी जस्ट कमेंट whether माय वॉइस इज क्लियर और नॉट. वॉइस क्लियर है? गुड मॉर्निंग शुभम. गुड मॉर्निंग. आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू शेयर दिस लिंक एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल सो दैट दोज गाइज हु आर नॉट इन्फॉर्म्ड अबाउट क्लास दे विल गेट इन्फॉर्म्ड बिकॉज टूडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. सो आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज टू बी अटेंडिंग दिस क्लास. चलिए सो लेट मी स्टार्ट दैट फर्स्ट. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल ए वेरी वेरी हैप्पी दुर्गा पूजा टू ऑल ऑफ यू. सो आप सब लोग अच्छा करो, मैं यही सोचूंगा और मैं यही प्रे भी करता हूं कि आप सब लोग अपने अपने लाइफ में जहां भी हो आप सब लोग अच्छा करो. चलिए सो लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट दिस. अमन यस, डेली क्लास आपकी 8 AM से ही होगी. डेली क्लास आपकी 8 AM से ही होगी. चलो लेट्स डिस्कस फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द वेटेज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इटसेल्फ इज हाउ मच. इट इज अराउंड 2 to 3 marks. द वेटेज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज नथिंग बट 2 to 3 marks. Now I will be dealing this complete chapter in two days, like today and tomorrow. What is the intention? That I will give you in a such a way that whether if you are giving ESC exam or GATE exam or any other exam, if any question will come from dimensional analysis part, you will be able to do it. Now regarding the importance of this dimensional analysis, what is the importance of this dimensional analysis? That I want to ask you. So after my intro, I will ask you very very basic question. What is the difference between unit and dimension? So you guys can think of, and then I will ask your comment. And then I will ask you in comment section. कि भैया मेरे को dimension और unit में difference बताओ. In a simple line, not something big. In a simple line. ठीक है. चलिए. So let me start the part. So those guys who are first time watching me, for them, my name is Mrigank Saurav, expert in GATE ESC and other technical exam for subjects like environmental engineering, fluid mechanics and open channel flow. You guys are well aware that I have already completed environmental engineering and open channel flow in this YouTube channel. And fluid mechanics currently it is going with the, this week we are going to start, we are already started the dimensional analysis part, and then we'll go with the boundary layer theory. So you have information malum hai. Regarding MTech in environmental engineering from NIT Warangal, it's good. I think some of your friend Haseeb Ahmed is asking me, sir, NIT Warangal ka environment kaisa hai? To dear, NIT Warangal ka environment bahut acha hai, college acha hai, aapko maza aayega. Aur best thing is that always select branch based on your interest. Agar aapka interest rahega to har branch acha hai. Agar aapka interest nahi rahega, sirf rank ke basis pe aapne branch select kiye, to aapke liye koi bhi branch bekar ho sakta hai. Regarding the MRI 10, that is my code, you all guys are knowing that, and those who are going for the plus subscription, they know that what are the benefit we are giving in a plus subscription. Not only the content part, but with that we know that the content is the best in the India, but thing is that other than the crash course, rank improvement batch, doubt solving session, weekly test, ye sari cheeze na bahut zaruri, it's very very important for you. Why? Because in online platform, the way of studying is little bit different as compared to the offline, that you guys are well aware. So weekly test, doubt solving session, these are very, very important tool to connect with that subject. And that is the reason this thing we are providing to all the students in the Plus platform. And that is very much beneficial that we have seen. Next, we can go with the fees part. You guys are well aware that now we have introduced 18-month course also. So 12-month course, 18-month course and 24-month course. Every course is available to you. You can go visit. And if you are dedicated about either GATE or ESC or any other exam, then only you can enjoy the plus part. क्योंकि वहाँ जो बच्चे मिलेंगे सब जो मिलेंगे आपको वहाँ जस्ट ग्रुप में ऐड हो गए आप वो सारे जो आपको ऐसे मिलेंगे जहाँ पे आपको क्या है सिर्फ गेट और ESC की बातें हो रही है. So that involvement is very much required. Regarding that package which we are providing in YouTube, you guys are well aware. You can check the playlist. This is my academy profile. You guys can follow me there also for the free content which we are providing. Like I have taken already the workout session for fluid mechanics also. Some of you guys have attended the yesterday workout session. Jin logon ne nahi attend kiya, they can comment me now. Sir, I didn't get the link and all. So aap usko dekhiyega. Kal ka workout session bahut hi acha tha because it is based on fluid dynamics concept, laminar flow and pipe flow. So these three topics which I have already covered in your YouTube lecture. Chalo. Regarding this Telegram group, you guys are well aware of this group name. Here you will get all the lecture notes as well as the class PDF. Our academy gates each channel, you guys are well aware. Now let me start the unit and dimension. So as I told you, after completing my intro, I will ask you very basic question to all of you. Bahut hi basic question. Difference between unit and dimension. मैं बहुत बेसिक से जाऊंगा बच्चा. I am started with the very very basic concept and so that आपको basics पहले clear हो जाएगा ना तो आप dimensional analysis तो खेलने लोगे. If your basics will be clear, you will start playing with the dimensional system. चलो. Shalu Sharma, those guys who have you have not seen that session, आप simple कुछ भी नहीं करना है. आप इस वीडियो के इस लेक्चर के डिस्क्रिप्शन सेक्शन में जाना, वहां आपको मेरी अनअकैडमी प्रोफाइल की लिंक मिलेगी, उस पर क्लिक कीजिएगा, मेरी प्रोफाइल खुलेगी, उसमें फ्री स्पेशल क्लासेस में जाना, आपको कल के फ्री स्पेशल क्लासेस में वो दिख जाएगा. सो दोज गाइज हु आर डेडिकेटेड अबाउट स्टडी, दोज गाइज हु वांट टू प्रैक्टिस सम गुड क्वेश्चन, दे कैन गो. चलिए. सो एज आई आस्क यू व्हाट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन यूनिट एंड डायमेंशन, वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन आई आस्क यू गाइज. A very basic question I asked you guys. So can you tell me? Can you guys tell me something in a comment section? Can you guys tell me something in a comment section? My question is to clear to all of you or not? Mera question clear hai ki nahi aap log se? What is the difference between unit and dimension? अगर आपको याद नहीं आ रहा तो मैं लिख देता हूं. देखो, यूनिट एंड डायमेंशन. वेरी बेसिक डिफरेंस. श्वांकित कुमार इज टेलिंग मी सर, डायमेंशन वी कैन मेजर बट वी नीड यूनिट वी कांट. इज इट लाइक दैट? अदर गाइज एग्री ऑन अंकित स्टेटमेंट? डू यू एग्री ऑन अंकित स्टेटमेंट? I'm asking to all of you, dear. Sivyala is telling me unit is a number, dimension is a number, but unit which specify that number. Oh, see how basic I am asking to you. मैं कितना basic question आपसे पूछ रहा हूँ, dear. आप देखो, कितना basic question मैं आपसे पूछ रहा हूँ. Dimension is a measurement. Oh, बहुत 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 सिंपल. अच्छा चलो, मैं क्वेश्चन को थोड़ा और सिंपलर करता हूं आपके लिए. Let me make this question very simple to you. Can any parameter will have more than one unit? क्या किसी भी पैरामीटर का एक से ज्यादा यूनिट हो सकता है? क्या किसी भी पैरामीटर का, फॉर एनी पैरामीटर, कैन इट हैव मोर देन वन यूनिट? आई एम आस्किंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू डियर. अमन भैया ये इंग्लिश की क्लास नहीं है, इट्स नॉट ए इंग्लिश क्लास जहां आपने एक लंबी सी लाइन लिख दी. नो 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 नो, टेल मी द सिंपल थिंग विच आई एम आस्किंग टू यू डियर. मैं बहुत सिंपल चीजें पूछता हूँ, मैं जब भी बच्चों से पूछता हूँ बहुत ही बेसिक्स पूछता हूँ. सो टेल मी द सिंपल थिंग, कैन एनी पैरामीटर विल हैव मोर देन वन यूनिट और नॉट? कैन एनी पैरामीटर विल हैव मोर देन वन यूनिट और नॉट? सबका जवाब आना चाहिए. दोज पीपल हु आर लाइव राइट नाउ, फॉर एग्जाम्पल, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट वेलोसिटी. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट वेलोसिटी. We have meter per second square, meter per second, centimeter per second, mm per second, feet per second. We have so many parameters. We have so many units for a given parameter. So, eight parameter clear for a given parameter. We have so many units. But what about dimension? For a given parameter, dimension will be a constant thing or it can be different also. It can be many other thing also. Question is very clear. Look at here. In a unit, we have centimeter per second, meter per second, mm per second, feet per second. But in a dimension, we will have only. See, look at what is the dimension of velocity? L. T minus 1. L T minus 1. Did you got that? Now, if you are taking meter per second, if you are taking centimeter per second, if you are taking mm per second, if you are taking feet per second, any unit which you are taking, but dimension will be always length upon time. So dimension is constant, it will not change. Unit can change. अगर SI यूनिट में लोगे कुछ अलग होगा, CGS यूनिट में लोगे कुछ अलग होगा, कुछ और भी यूनिट होगी उसमें अलग होगा. सो दैट इज द रीजन. सो इन अ यूनिट डियर यूनिट्स कैन बी डिफरेंट बट डायमेंशन विल बी ऑलवेज कांस्टेंट. डिड यू गॉट दैट पॉइंट? क्या सब लोग को ये बात समझ में आई? डियर मैं बहुत बेसिक से जा रहा हूं, सो आई एम एक्सपेक्टिंग यू गाइज टू कॉपरेट विथ मी. एक एक चीजें समझो फिर आगे बढ़ेंगे. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू डियर? You got the difference between unit and dimension? चलिए सब लोग बताइएगा. You got the difference between unit and dimension? Yes or no, dear? Yes or no? चलो. So first thing you understood, difference between unit and dimension. Next thing will be that. Look at it. Why dimensional analysis is required? Why dimensional analysis is required? Why dimensional analysis is required? Very, very, very important topic. Now, for example, look at it. For example, you have a function like q. It is a function of x also, y also, z also, t also, anything else also, omega also. So it's a function of all these things. So if you want to get a relation from this, आपको क्या करना पड़ेगा? फॉर ईच पैरामीटर यू हैव टू डू द ऑब्जर्वेशन. अब एक पैरामीटर में, फॉर ए सिंगल पैरामीटर, योर ऑब्जर्वेशन विल नॉट बी डिपेंड अपॉन ऑन ए सिंगल आउटकम ना. यू हैव टू डू आई थिंक एन नंबर ऑफ आउटकम. सो फॉर ईच पैरामीटर यू हैव टू डू एन नंबर ऑफ आउटकम. द रिजल्ट विल बी वेरी मच कॉम्प्लिकेटेड. सो दिस डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस हेल्प्स यू to make a relation between that dependent variable and independent variable in a such a way that it will not be so complicated. वो अब बहुत ज्यादा complicated नहीं होगा, वो easy कर देता है, बहुत easy कर देता है. अब हर parameter का 100, अब समझो, अगर by the way अगर आपने 100 observation लिया, for x you have taken 100 observation, for y you have taken 100 observation, for z you have taken again 100 observation, for t again you have taken 100 observation, for omega again 100 observation. So total how many? 500 observation. And to make that possible, it is going to be very, very complicated. And there this dimensional analysis will help you. So dimensional analysis is majorly required for two purposes. First thing, look at in generation of pi term. I will tell you what is this pi term. Agar dekho, iska agar main in a single line, if I want to tell you the objective of this dimensional analysis is that you know now Reynolds number, Froude number, Weber number, Mach number, Euler number. These all number is nothing but it's a part of the dimensional analysis part. So is that clear to you? Is that you can see the wide scope? You can see the wide scope of this. So first thing is the generation of pi term. What about second thing? Aap log kya second thing bata sakte ho? Is the model analysis. I will tell you what is model analysis. I will tell you what is prototype. I will tell you why this model analysis is required. But I think you got that point that in the dimensional analysis chapter, the major two part will be what? It will be generation of pi term and model analysis. Is that clear to you? I'm asking to all of you. यहां तक बातें समझ में आई या नहीं आई? चलो अब इसके आगे चलते हैं. Let's go to the next one. Fourier concept of homogeneity. अब यहां दो टर्म बहुत समझना जरूरी है. Your two term is very much required to understand. एक होता है, one is homogeneity, जिसको हम बोलते हैं homogeneous, and second thing is consistent. So one is homogeneous and non-homogeneous. Second and third and fourth is what? Consistent and inconsistent. You need to understand what is homogeneous and what is consistent and all. सब लोग ध्यान समझना. First, let me talk about homogeneity. Take a equation. For example, take which equation? V square equal to U square plus 2S. I think you guys are well aware of this. So V square equal to U, V square minus U square equal to 2S. Same formula only. So look at here. Everyone look at here. What is this? V. What is your unit of this? L square upon T square. Here also, L square upon T square plus 2S. L square upon T square. So in all the section, in all the part which you have seen that, the dimensions are same. Is that clear or not? So if the in each term, if the dimensions are same, that's something we call as homogeneous. इसको हम क्या बोलते हैं बच्चा? Homogeneous. But if f equal to, for example, if f equal to 9.81 m, where m is something we can take as mass. So f equal to 9.81. Now you guys will tell me कि क्या यहां पे ये होमोजीनियस है, whether this equation is homogeneous or not. अब आप लोग बताओगे. If this thing is clear to you, you guys will tell me whether this is homogeneous or not. F equal to 9.81 m, is it a homogeneous equation or not? You guys will comment and tell me fast. जल्दी बताना सब लोग.
चलिए जल्दी बताइएगा सब लोग. आई एम लुकिंग इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. जल्दी बताइए सब लोग. चलिए वाशु आ गए हैं. वाशु इज इन कमेंट सेक्शन. वाशु आई होप योर हेल्थ इज नाउ ओके. यू हैव मैसेज मी अबाउट योर हेल्थ. यस 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 इट इज ए F is something force. You can take this as a force. So F is force. M is mass. Here it is a Newton. That means it's a what is that? Force equal to mass into acceleration. So kg into meter per second square. Here it is only mass. So in both the side the dimensions are not same. So this is non-homogeneous. Non-homogeneous. Very very basic concept. Without Fourier concept, you will not understand the generation of pi term. So everyone just look at here. Next point. Look at here. F equal to ma. Now the term came consistent and inconsistent. Consistent and inconsistent. Look at it. If I am going to use F equal to ma in moon, मैं moon में use करूं, क्या वहां valid होगा ये? Whether this formula will be valid there? क्या F equal to ma will be valid in moon, on the surface of moon? Or yes or no? Yes, it will be valid. And same thing will valid in earth also. So F equal to ma, it is nothing but it is valid in every situation. That formula we call as consistent. Consistent. But if you see Manning's equation, क्या होता है Manning's equation? 1 by n r to power 2 by 3 s to power 1 by 2. Now you guys will tell me whether this equation is consistent or inconsistent. मैं आपसे clear सवाल पूछ रहा हूं, whether this equation is consistent or inconsistent. Whether this equation is consistent or inconsistent. I'm asking very, very basic question to you. I just want you to understand what is homogeneity, what is consistent. If I'm telling if any formula is homogeneous and consistent, what is the meaning of that? That is the reason I'm giving you this example. Aur kitne din chalega, Sharban? Maybe your FM will complete, most probably, according to my plan, it will complete in first week of November. In the first week of November. Is that clear? Chalo. Is it a consistent or not? Is it a consistent formula or not? No. It is not consistent here because this is valid only in a gravity flow, in open channel flow. So this is inconsistent formula. It is not valid in every aspect. It is not valid in every aspect. So I have told you it is inconsistent. But my question will be that whether it is homogeneous or non-homogeneous. Whether this formula is homogeneous formula or non-homogeneous formula. I'm asking to all of you. Jaldi batao. I'm asking to all of you, dear. All of you. Is it a homogeneous or a non-homogeneous? If you look at the left side and the right side, if they try to balance the dimension part, it is not going to balance. So it is nothing but what, dear? It is non-homogeneous. So remember my point. Always empirical formula are always non-homogeneous. And the analytical formula, which you have derived that formula, is almost always, you can say, it is a homogeneous. So, hamesa empirical formula non-homogeneous hota hai. And the analytical formula, which you have derived, that is always homogeneous. Remember that point. I think I want to ask from all of you, dear, जो मैं बताना चाह रहा हूं कि क्या आपको कंसिस्टेंट इनकंसिस्टेंट होमोजीनियस नॉन होमोजीनियस ये समझ में आ गया. वेदर यू गॉट दैट व्हाट इज कंसिस्टेंट व्हाट इज इनकंसिस्टेंट व्हाट इज होमोजीनियस व्हाट इज नॉन होमोजीनियस ये एकदम कंप्लीट पिक्चर क्लियर हुई है नहीं? द पिक्चर इज क्लियर और नॉट? अभी मैंने बेसिक्स में हूं, स्टिल आई हैव नॉट टच इवन अ सिंगल टॉपिक ऑफ डायमेंशनलेसनेस.
अभी मैं बेसिक्स में हूं, राइट नाउ आई मीन बेसिक, आई वॉन्ट टू क्लियर दैट फर्स्ट, आई वॉन्ट टू क्लियर दैट फर्स्ट, अदरवाइज आपको प्रॉब्लम होगी आगे. Charu Sharma, you will get all my lecture on that app. If you go to that profile, and if you go to my Unacademy profile, you will find complete workout session which I have taken on fluid mechanics. So for your practice, you can use that. You can use for content, you can use the YouTube lecture, and for practice, you can use the workout session. तो ये आप कीजिएगा, बहुत फायदा होगा आपको. And similarly, you can do for environment also. चलो. So picture is clear to all of you. Infinity भैया, lift and drag will be it's part of boundary layer. So I will discuss you after completing my boundary layer theory. That also I will teach you. Don't worry. चलो, अगर आप लोग को ये चीज़ समझ में आ गई, if you guys understood about the homogeneity part. Now I will tell you the first topic. That's something we call as generation of pyrethrum. Generation of pyrethrum. Empirical formula will be inconsistent also. Yes, empirical formula will be inconsistent also. Somebody is asking me. चल, अब देखो, इसमें दो method है हमारे पास. In generation of pyrethrum, we have two method which we have. First one we call as Buckingham pi method. Buckingham pi theorem. और इसी को लोग कभी ये भी बोलते हैं method of repeating variable. Second one is Rayleigh method. Now Rayleigh method become obsolete matlab it is outdated, and this is something which you need to know. I will also tell you, I will not discuss the Rayleigh method because nobody will ask you question from that, especially in GATE exam. So but I will tell you in detail about Buckingham pi theorem, and why I'm not discussing Rayleigh method, because this Rayleigh method is having some demerits, and because of that it is not widely used. That is the reason the Rayleigh method become now obsolete, and I will give you the reason after explaining the Buckingham pi theorem. At the last, I will give you the reason why Rayleigh method is not suitable for our condition, why Rayleigh method is not widely used. I will tell you the reason. So right now I want to focus you in the first, that is Buckingham pi theorem. So sab log yahan dhyan dijiyega, everybody just look at here. Now what I'm going to explain you Buckingham pi method, a complete method by solving a problem. Thoda different kar raha hu main. What I'm doing here, I'm giving a problem to you, and while explaining this problem I will tell you how this method, what is the procedure of this method. That complete detail I will tell you. So is it okay to all of you? Chalo. Now everyone look at here. In this question, what they have mentioned you, the thrust F acting on a shaft of a ship depends upon the diameter d of the shaft, speed of the average, that something is density also, angular velocity also, viscosity also. This derive the possible number of pyrethrum. सब लोग ध्यान से देखिएगा, पूरा मेथड ध्यान समझना, कोई भी बीच में मेथड को छोड़ेगा नहीं, ध्यान समझना. So I can write that f is a function of what? Diameter, velocity, rho density, omega, and viscosity. So f is a function of d, v, rho, omega, and v. Chale. Now here you need to understand what is dependent variable and what is independent variable. So here
F is what? F is dependent variable or independent variable? My question is to all of you. Here I have given you that the force or the thrust is nothing but it's a function of D, that is the diameter, V, mu, rho, omega. Inside ka function. So here you have two type of variable. Either it will be a dependent variable or independent variable. My question is that whether F is independent or dependent. It is independent variable. It is independent variable. And what about this? This is dependent variable. This is dependent variable. F is independent variable and this is dependent variable. Is that clear to all of you or not? Is that clear to all of you or not? So, I think I've written it wrong. Sorry guys. So F is actually dependent on what? D, V, rho, omega and mu. So that means F is dependent on these things. That F is dependent variable and D, V, rho, omega, mu. These are independent variable. So now total variable is nothing but what? Total variable is nothing but what? Number of dependent variable. Plus number of independent variable. Number of independent variable. Now this total number we represent as n. This kum kya is represent karte hai? N se. So basically kya ho gaya? This is your n. This is your n. So n is nothing but sum of total number of dependent variable plus total number of independent variable. Is that clear to all of you? Is that clear to all of you? How do we classify? Kuch log pooch rahe hain sir, how do we classify? Look at here, Charu Sharma, look at here. Ye jo aapki f ki value kis pe dependent yahan mention hai? D pe, V pe, rho pe, mu, omega pe, mu pe. That means f is kis pe? F, the f value of f is depending on D, V, rho, mu and omega. So that is the reason this is dependent variable. And D, V, rho, omega and mu. This is not at all dependent on anything. So that is the reason we told that is independent variable. Is that clear to you? Is that clear to you, Charu Sharma? Now look at here. So, aap agar bolo, for this question, if I will ask you, what is n? What is the number of n? What is the number of n? What is the number of total variable? So, dependent variable we have 1 and independent variable we have 5. So, total we have n equal to 6. Total we have n equal to 6. Chalo. Next thing dekho. M. Next thing is M. That's something we call as number of repeating variable. Number of repeating variable. Ab aapka pehla sawal hoga, sir, what is repeating variable? First thing you guys will ask me, sir, what is repeating variable? Ye ek bar bata dijiye. So what is repeating variable? Kya hoti repeating variable? Everything I will tell you. Just listen for 2 minutes now. Just listen for 2 minutes now. Ek baar dekhna sab log. First rule for the repeating variable. In a repeating variable, it has to contain. Everyone just look at here. It has to contain. It should contain SLX sector. It should contain all the primary. I am telling you how to select a repeating variable. So, pehle samajna, uske baad doubt puchna. It should contain all the primary basic unit. Basic unit. Or basic fundamental unit also you can say. Basic fundamental unit. Like M, L, T, that is such as mass, length and time.
सेकेंड पॉइंट, सेकेंड पॉइंट लिख लीजिएगा, डोंट चूज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल डोंट चूज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एज रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल। ये रूल्स समझना बच्चा, अगर रूल्स नहीं समझोगे ना यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू फाइनलाइज विच इज रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल। फर्स्ट रूल व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू दैट इट शुड कंटेन ऑल द प्राइमरी बेसिक फंडामेंटल यूनिट, दैट मींस एम एल टी, ये सारी चीजें होनी चाहिए उसमें। नेक्स्ट थिंग इज डोंट चूज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एज रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल, मतलब here in this question we can't take f as a repeating variable, we can't take f as a repeating variable. So definitely you say sir this is the rule, but what is the method of selection, what is the method of, what is the selection criteria? So the next point, something related to repeating variable only, that is criteria for selection of repeating variable, criteria for selection of repeating variable. Everybody just listen here, everybody just listen here. We have three criteria. First one is geometrical criteria. Second one is kinematic criteria. And the third one is dynamic criteria. आपके पास तीन criteria. Example समझिएगा, example से आप समझ लोगे. In a geometrical criteria you have d, length, volume, area. So these are geometrical criteria, these are nothing but geometrical criteria. In a kinematic criteria you have, एग्जाम्पल से आप समझ लोगे, वेलोसिटी, एक्सेलरेशन, आफ्टर दैट रेट, रेट ऑफ फ्लो दैट इज क्यू। इन डायमेट्रिक क्राइटेरिया इट विल बी रिलेटेड टू द फ्लूइड प्रॉपर्टीज लाइक रो, म्यू, दिस विल बी द नथिंग बट द डायमिक, यू कैन से डायमिक क्राइटेरिया। सो इसको हम डायनेमिक क्राइटेरिया भी बोलते हैं या डायनेमिक फ्लूइड कैरेक्टरिस्टिक भी बोलते हैं, दो चीजें। अब मैं आपका कमेंट पूछ रहा हूं, अब मैं आपका कमेंट पूछ रहा हूं, ध्यान से बताना। आई टोल्ड यू द क्लासिफिकेशन, व्हाट इज द रूल ऑफ दैट, दैट आल्सो आई टोल्ड यू, आई टोल्ड यू द क्राइटेरिया ऑफ द सिलेक्शन फॉर द रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल। सो ऑल द क्राइटेरिया हैज टू बी फुलफिल्ड, एक ज्योमेट्रिकल क्राइटेरिया भी होना चाहिए, एक कैनेटिक क्राइटेरिया भी होना चाहिए, एक डायनेमिक क्राइटेरिया भी होना चाहिए। सो ऑल द क्राइटेरिया हैज टू बी फुलफिल्ड, बट एवरी क्वेश्चन एवरी क्राइटेरिया विल बी देयर, इट इज नॉट कंपलसरी, ऐसा कंपलसरी नहीं है। बट इफ इन क्वेश्चन इफ दे हैव गिवन यू, you have to select a geometrical criteria, you have to select a kinematic criteria, you have to select a dynamic criteria. So now I'm going back to the question, I'm going back to the question. I told you what is repeating variable, how we are going, I didn't tell you the exact meaning of the repeating variable, but I told you what how we can find out this repeating variable. So go back to the problem, go back to the problem, and you guys will tell me what is the m, what is the number of m, m ki value kya hogi, sirf question dekho aur batao. Look at the question and tell me. सब लोग ध्यान से एक बार क्वेश्चन देखिएगा और बताइएगा, what is the value of m, what is the value of m, this I'm asking to all of you dear, ये मैं आप सबसे पूछ रहा हूं, what is the value of m, what is the value of m here, what is the value of m here, I'm asking to all of you. So if you are selecting your repeating variable, you can select, for geometrical criteria you can select d, okay, for kinematic criteria you can select v, and for dynamic fluid criteria you can select rho. So m is nothing but what, m is 3. So for this question m value, for this question
m value is equal to 3. M value is equal to 3. So look at here. Number of pi term is equal to n minus m. N is 6 minus 3, 3. That means total 3 number of pi term which you will get in this relation. In this relation between f and other variable. So here you will get total number of 3 pi term. Total number of 3 pi term. Ab dekhiyega. Let's see whether whatever we have taken d, velocity and rho. In tino ka dimension likhiyega ek bar. Write down the dimension for this. For d it will be l. For v it will be l t minus 1. For rho it will be sorry guys. Mass upon volume. So mass l to the power minus q. So aapke paas mass aa gaya, time bhi aa gaya, length bhi aa gaya. That means it is satisfying all the basic fundamental basic unit. In this d, v and rho, it is having all the basic fundamental units. Next thing is that we have not taken f. We have not taken f. That is why we have not taken. Why? Because that is dependent variable. We never take dependent variable as repeating variable. Ye maine aapko rule bataya tha. Do rule maine bataya. Based on both the rule, this d, v, rho we can take. D, v, rho we can take. Now, everyone. Aman is asking me, sir. Ankit is telling me, sir, viscosity is also there. Viscosity is also there. If you want dl, you can take viscosity also. If you want, you can take viscosity also. Yahan koi fixed term nahi hai ki main, for my calculation, I have taken d, v and rho. If you want, you can take mu also. That is not a problem here. That is not a problem here. You will get a different pi term. You will get a different pi term. So, this question mein aapne jo select kiya, wo aapka clear hona chahiye. What you are selecting? D, V and rho. So, here I am selecting D, V and rho. You also guys have to select D, V and rho. If you want to practice, instead of rho, you can take mu. Instead of rho, you can take mu. Instead of V, you can take omega also. That is angular velocity. So, that also you can take. It's up to you. There is no fix. There is no fix that I have to take D, V and rho also. Yehi compulsory aisa kuch nahi hai. आपको रूल्स फॉलो होने चाहिए. रूल्स क्या है कि ऑल एम एंड एल इट शुड कंटेन ऑल प्राइमरी बेसिक फंडामेंटल यूनिट एंड सेकंड थिंग इज दैट डोंट चूज डिपेंडेंट वेरिएबल एज रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल. ये दोनों रूल फॉलो होने चाहिए. दिस रूल हैज टू बी फॉलो. दैट्स इट. इज दैट क्लियर? इज दैट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? अंकित यू हैव आस्क्ड अबाउट दैट. अमन आपको क्लियर हुई चीजें? जिसकी भी थोड़ी सी भी डाउट है वो पूछ लो. Even you have a small doubt, you can ask me. Even you guys are having a small doubt, you can ask me. Chali. Now, before going to find out the dimensionless number, what I am asking to you, you guys will tell me f, d. After that, I think velocity is there. Then mu is there. Then omega is there. Then rho is there. Chali. You guys have to tell me the dimensions of this number. If this variable, dimensions of this variable, difficult wala main bataunga, easier wala aap log batao. So difficult matlab d ke liye dimension hoti hai l, velocity ke liye l t minus 1, omega ke liye t minus 1, rho ke liye m l minus 3. Ab jo easy wala jo hai na, jo f or mu jo easy hai, wo aap log bata do. Wo to aap log bata do. I know you guys are very 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 great. Wo aap log bata do. Aman is telling, sir, not clear, sir. Aman, dear, you can take, see, in a repeating variable, you have to always select based on the selection criteria. One you have to take from geometrical criteria, one you have to take from kinetic criteria, one you have to take from dynamic criteria. In the variable, in the question, if all these three criteria are given, in that case, m will be always 3. Kabhi kabhi aisa hoga, in some situation it will happen, geometrical criteria is not given or fluid properties criteria is not given. So in that case your m can be 2 also. But all these criteria we will always find out. In a general problem we always try to find out geometrical criteria, kinematic criteria and dynamic criteria. We have to always find out. Is that clear? Now why I have selected m equal to 3? No one, not every term has to contain m, l and t. आपका ये समेशन में m और l t तीनों होना चाहिए.
हर एक टर्म आपको एमएलटी रखेगा, ऐसा थोड़ी है। इज दैट क्लियर? हर एक टर्म आपको एमएलटी रखेगा ऐसा क्लियर थोड़ी है। अब इफ यू हैव लाइक डायमीटर दैट इज नॉट हैविंग मास टर्म, सो व्हाट इज द फॉल्ट इन दैट? कोई फॉल्ट नहीं उसका। सो इन अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस थ्री, इन अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस थ्री इट विल हैव एमएलटी, कॉम्बिनेशन में होना चाहिए, कॉम्बिनेशन में होना चाहिए। इज दैट क्लियर? You can say maximum value of repeating variable is 3. Maximum value of repeating variable is 3. Yes, you can see that. Is that clear, dear? Is that clear, dear? क्या बातें समझ में आई? जब तक आप लोग समझोगे नहीं, until unless you are not understanding, I will not go to the next step. मैं next step में नहीं जाऊंगा, क्योंकि यहां समझना बहुत जरूरी है बच्चा। इफ यू आर नॉट गेटिंग ना, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू सॉल्व दैट प्रॉब्लम इन अ गेट एग्जाम। आप प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व नहीं कर पाओगे। सो इफ एन नंबर ऑफ टाइम आई हैव टू रिपीट, आई विल रिपीट इट फॉर यू, नो प्रॉब्लम डियर। कोई जल्दीबाजी मेरे को नहीं है, बट मैं चाहता हूं आपको मैथड क्लियर हो। मैथड शुड बी वेरी वेरी क्लियर इन योर माइंड। चलो आप आगे बढ़ू। चलिए, तो आप लोगों ने इजी वाला बता दिया था मेरे को, इजी वाला बताया कि नहीं आप लोगों ने? एफ का क्या होगा? व्हाट इज द एफ? एफ एफ डायमेंशनलेस, एम एल टी माइनस टू। व्हाट अबाउट म्यू? एम एल माइनस वन टी माइनस वन, एम एल माइनस वन टी माइनस वन। आई थिंक ये बात सबको समझ में आ गई होगी। हाउ आई हैव कैलकुलेटेड दिस डायमेंशंस, कैसे डायमेंशंस लिखे जाते हैं, वो आई थिंक आप सब लोग को आता होगा। इफ टेम्परेचर कम्स इन देन एम कैन बी फोर। अगर टेम्परेचर एक्स्ट्रा आ गया, सो टेम्परेचर इज अ फ्लूइड प्रॉपर्टीज। टेम्परेचर में आपको फ्लूइड प्रॉपर्टीज, टेम्परेचर इज नॉट, टेम्परेचर एक आउट टर्म है। टेम्परेचर से आपको फ्लूइड प्रॉपर्टीज पे इफेक्ट पड़ रहा होगा। यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द इंडिपेंडेंट क्वांटिटी। टेम्परेचर आप इंक्रीज डिक्रीज करते तो क्या होगा? विस्कोसिटी चेंज होगी ना, द फ्लूइड प्रॉपर्टीज विल चेंज ना। सो वी विल फाइंड दैट। सो इफ टेम्परेचर आएगा तो टाइम आपका एम चार हो जाएगा, ऐसा कुछ भी नहीं है। इज दैट क्लियर और नॉट? दिस इज फॉर यू वाशु। इज दैट क्लियर और नॉट? चलिए, तो यू नो हाउ टू फाइंड आउट एफ एंड म्यू, सो दैट यू ऑलरेडी गेव मी दैट। फॉर एम इट इज एम एल टी माइनस वन, फॉर म्यू इट इज एम एल माइनस वन टी माइनस वन। चलिए, now first everyone look at here, what I am going to do, I will explain you how to find out pi term first, because three pi term you need to find out. First one I will explain you, second and third you guys will give it. चलिए, तो सब लोग ध्यान से देखिएगा। pi 1 फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल पाई वन, सो पाई वन इज इक्वल टू फर्स्ट केस डी वन टू द पावर ए वन, नेक्स्ट वन और इंस्टेड ऑफ डी वन यू कैन राइट सिंपली डी, दैट विल बी ऑल्सो ओके ए वन। दूसरा रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल, सेकेंड रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल व्हाट वी हैव, कौन कौन सा लिए थे हम लोगों ने? डी वी एंड रो, ओके v to the power b1, rho to the power c1. After that, other than the dependent variable, you can say other than the repeating variable, what are the quantity you have? You have to take that quantity. कौन कौन से quantity हमारे पास? So let's take first time, you can take mu. Mu लेके देखते हैं. Take this mu. चलो. Now pi1 is a dimensionless number. So for that, we can write m to power 0, l to the power 0, and t to power 0. For d, we have dimension l, a1. For v, we have dimension l, t minus 1, b1. For rho, that is a density. So that is what? Mass upon volume. So l, m l minus 3 to the power c1. And for mu, we have m l, l minus 1, t minus 1. There's something which I have written here also. Chali. Now what we'll do, both sides we are equating. So I can write this as M0, L0,
and t0 is equal to m to the power c1 plus 1 l to the power a1 plus v1 minus 3c1 minus 1. If I think I'm not wrong here. और देखते हैं और क्या है आपके पास, और क्या है आपके पास, और क्या है आपके पास, टी. सो टी यू हैव माइनस बी वन एंड माइनस वन. आई थिंक कंप्लीटली आई हैव रिटन. नाउ इक्वेट लेफ्ट एंड राइट साइड बोथ. नाउ इक्वेट लेफ्ट एंड राइट साइड बोथ. So if you are equating, what you are getting? Equation आपको क्या आ रही है? First equation you are getting c1 plus 1 equal to 0. First equation. Second equation a1 plus b1 minus 3c1 minus 1 is equal to 0. Next one is minus b1 minus 1 equal to 0. First equation, second equation and third equation. Now tell me the value. Tell me the value. So you got c1 equal to what? Minus 1. B1 equal to what? Minus 1. Put it here. Put it here. So minus 1, minus 1, minus 3 c1, minus 1 equal to 0. So what is the value of c1 you are getting? 3c1 will be equal to what? Minus 3. So c1 will be equal to minus 1. So you got the value of a1, b1 and c1. A1, b1 and c1. Oh, sorry, sorry, sorry. I think I have done here something incorrect. So this is a1 na, a1 minus b1 plus 3, yes, minus 1 equal to 0. Now it's okay. So a1 will be equal to minus 3 plus 2. So a1 you are getting minus 1. So a1 is also minus 1, b1 is also minus 1 and c1 is also minus 1. So you got the value of a1, b1 and c1. Abhi main aapko bilkul, I'm not taking any of your doubt. Please look at here. Please look at the calculation first. Now I'm going to put this a1, b1 and c1 value in this equation. In this equation. Look at what we are getting. Look at what we are getting. Pi1 is equal to d to the power minus 1, v to the power minus 1, rho to the power minus 1 into mu. Into mu. So pi1 will be equal to mu upon rho v d. If I will write 1 upon pi 1, it is rho v d upon mu. Rho v d upon mu. Aap log batana. Whether rho v d upon mu, what we call this thing? What we call this thing? Rho v d upon mu ko aap kya bolte ho? If we have taken viscosity, the value of m equal to 1. Why dear? Agar aapne viscosity loge, if you have taken viscosity dear, if you have taken the viscosity, kahan pe viscosity lena tha? In place of rho. No problem, you can take a different pi term will come. A different pi term will come. Why I'm telling you to take rho only here? Because I'm going to explain you through rho. If you want, you can take mu also. In place of rho, you can take mu also. So as I told you, in any you can take, like diameter, area, both you can take. Velocity, omega, that also you can take. Rho, mu, in any of them you can take. So it's totally depend on you. Here I have taken dv and rho. You want you in a separate way, you can do different also. Yahan main aapko yahi karne bol raha hu taki hum answer match kar paaye. Otherwise, hum dono ka answer different aayega. What I am solving, that will be different. What you guys are solving, that will be different. That is the reason I am telling you to take dv and rho also. For a practice, you can take mu also in place of rho. So accordingly, the value will change. Accordingly, the pi term will also change. Sure. So now you guys are commenting, what is that number? What is that number? Sir, if you have taken viscosity, the value of Aman, aapka doubt clear ho gaya? Sir, in a fundamental unit along with the mass, length and time, temperature also there, na? Vashu, in a fundamental unit, mass, length and time, that is given to you. Mass, length and time, that is given to you. So you have converted that, that is a fundamental basic unit, na? That is a fundamental basic unit. If you are taking any other parameter, if you are taking any other parameter, it will be converted into that only, na? It will be converted into that only, na? Are you getting my point? These are the basic unit which will be there, which will be there. Did you got that point? Did you got that point? Is that clear? Aman, aap log ne isliye main bolta hu, you guys have not focusing about the rules which I told you. What I told you, what line I told you, Aman, that in a selection of repeating variable, you have to satisfy all these parameters, not only dynamic fluid criteria. You have to satisfy geometric criteria also, you have to satisfy kinematic criteria also, you have to satisfy dynamic criteria also. Ye tino criteria aapke satisfy hona chahiye. Until and unless in that problem no geometrical criteria is there, in that case only you will not take geometrical thing. Agar hoga to lena padega. To ye mat bolo ki sir, in dynamics we have M, L and T both, so why you are not talking this? पूरी कहानी आप लोग नहीं सुनते हो, दैट इज द रीजन, दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम विद यू गाइस. आप पूरी कहानी, मैंने क्या बोला आपको, आफ्टर टेलिंग द कंप्लीट डिटेल अबाउट द सिलेक्शन क्राइटेरिया व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू एट द लास्ट, आई हैव गिवन यू दिस लाइन दैट एनी रिपीटिंग, इफ यू आर सेलेक्टिंग रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल, इट हैज टू सेटिस्फाई ऑल दीज थ्री क्राइटेरिया. ओनली इन दैट केस वेयर लाइक ज्योमेट्रिकल क्राइटेरिया इज कंप्लीटली एब्सेंट, इन ओनली इन दैट केस एम वैल्यू विल बी नॉट थ्री, इट विल बी समथिंग लेस देन दैट, तभी होगा. इज दैट क्लियर टू यू और नॉट? अभी दोबारा मत पूछना, बता रहा हूं. वो क्लोरोमिन खाए हो ना आप लोग, दोबारा मत पूछना. मैं आपको दो तीन बार बता रहा हूं, और भी चाहिए तो और भी बार बताऊंगा, लेकिन समझ के जाओ. ये अमन का फिर से वही डाउट है. दैट इज द रीजन आई एम आस्किंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, अदर देन अमन आई एम आस्किंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू, whether I have given this line or not, this statement I told you or not, that any in selection of repeating variable, you have to satisfy all these criteria, geometrical also, kinematic also, dynamic also, all these criteria has to satisfy. Then you will see that the rules are applied or not. Then you will see the rules are applied or not. Uske baad dekhna hai ki aapka rules apply ho raha hai ya nahi. Is that clear? वैल्यू सबकी डिफरेंट आ सकती है. यस, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ यू इंस्टीड ऑफ रो वी डी इफ यू हैव टेकन डी ओमेगा एंड म्यू, आपकी पाई टर्म डिफरेंट आएगी, योर पाई टर्म विल बी डिफरेंट. दैट इज द रीजन आई एम टेलिंग यू ना गाइस, कि गो विथ रो वी डी, ताकि हम और आप आंसर मैच कर सके. अदरवाइज मैं किसी और रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल को लेकर सॉल्व कर रहा हूं, आप किसी और रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल को लेकर शो कर रहे हो, तो कहां से आंसर मैच करेगा? Did you got that point? Did you got that point? If you want to practice, you can practice with the taking d, omega and mu also. No problem. Is that clear? Are yes or no, dear? Yes or no? Baatein samajh mein aayi? Have you guys understood this or not? चलो अब यहां पे आ जाओ. व्हाट आई टोल्ड यू, दिस इज समथिंग वी गॉट एज नथिंग बट रेनॉल्ड्स नंबर. सो व्हेनेवर यू आर फाइंडिंग आउट अ पाई टर्म, यू विल ऑलवेज गेट अ डायमेंशनलेस नंबर, रो वी डी म्यू, एंड दैट्स समबडी इज आस्किंग मी सर करेक्ट है, कैसे पता चलेगा? सो व्हेन यू विल गेट अ डायमेंशनलेस नंबर, इट्स इंडिकेशन फॉर यू दैट यू गॉट द करेक्ट रिजल्ट. Is that clear to all of you, dear? बातें समझ में आई? तो अगर ये बातें समझ में आ गई है, if you got the pi one part, I am hoping that you guys will give me next thing, pi two. आप सब लोग मेरे को pi two दे सकते हो क्या?
सो पाई टू के लिए भी मैं आपको लिख देता हूं ताकि आपको प्रॉब्लम ना हो. डी ए टू वी बी टू रो सी टू एंड विद दैट वी हैव दिस टाइम लास्ट टाइम वी हैव टेकन म्यू दिस टाइम आई एम टेकिंग ओमेगा. दिस टाइम आई एम टेकिंग ओमेगा. अब आपका काम है यू हैव टू टेल मी द पाई टू वैल्यू. अब आपका काम है यू हैव टू टेल मी द पाई टू वैल्यू. नाउ आई विल टेक रेस्ट एंड यू गाइस विल टेल मी द पाई टू वैल्यू. अब देखते हैं कितनों को समझ में आया. नाउ विल सी हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू गाइस विल हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू गाइस अंडरस्टूड दिस. हाउ मेनी ऑफ यू गाइस हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस. चलो पाई टू पाई टू पाई टू. What is the pi to value? What is the pi to value? What is the pi to value? As I told you, if you are getting something formula or something like this, in that case you can go like that. कि आपकी value सही आई है. आपको एक last में जो मिलेगी that will be something a formula. अंकित कुमार यादव यस इससे गेट में आ सकता है. आई विल गिव यू क्वेश्चन इन व्हाट वे दे कैन आस्क यू दैट आल्सो आई विल गिव इट टू यू. आई विल गिव यू द क्वेश्चन आल्सो हाउ द क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड इन दिस पार्ट. चलो अभी फटाफट बताओ आप सब लोग यहां पे पाई टू लेंथ ए टू एल टी माइनस वन बी टू ML minus 3 C2 and for omega we have T minus 1. So this pi 2 is again M0 L0 and T0. So M0 L0 T0 will be equal to M to the power C2 L to the power A2 plus B2 minus 3 C2 and t to the power minus b2 minus 1. Chali. C2 value will be equal to 0. Minus b2 equal to 0. So b2 value will be equal to minus 1. Next thing. A2 minus 1. And 0. So A2 will be equal to 1. So A2 we got 1. B2 we got minus 1. And C2 we got 0. I don't think so anybody will have any problem in this. Kisi ko bhi is baat se koi problem hai to batao. Mass hamare paas sirf C2 hi hai. So that will be 0. B2 is minus 1. A2 is 1. Check. Let's put this part here. So pi 2 will be equal to jin logo ko lag raha hoga ye method lamba ja raha hai, they will not ask you to find out all the pi term, they will ask you to find out a single pi term. So remember that. Chali pi 2 equal to what will be that d a 2 value is how much. Okay, with that v minus 1 with that c 2 0 into omega. So pi 2 something we can write like this d into omega upon v. D into omega upon v. So you know, have you heard about this formula v equal to omega r? Kya aap log ne ye formula padha tha? Have you guys heard about this formula? So this something we can write as v equal to d omega upon pi 2. That means v is something function of d and omega. So this formula you guys have heard about or not? Aapne v equal to omega r padha hai ya nahi? V equal to omega r you guys have heard about. So you can again relate that whether your value is correct or not. Aap relate kar sakte ho. You can relate again.
Is that clear or not? As I told you that every time you will get a dimensionless number. Pi 2 again here it's a dimensionless. Pi 2 again here it's a dimensionless. What is the unit of D? It's L. What is the unit of omega? It's T minus 1. So L upon T. Below in denominator part, the velocity. What is the unit of velocity? L upon T. So L upon T and L upon T both will get cancel out. So again you are getting a dimensionless term. Again you are getting a dimensionless term. We are going to the next one here. Pi 3. So D to the power A 3, V to the power B 3 and rho to the power C 3. And with that we have now only one is remaining, that is F. F is only thing which is remaining. Chalo. So this is M0 L0 T0 equal to L to the power A3 L T minus 1 B3 M L minus 3 to power C3 M L T minus 2. That's something which I have already told you here. Chale. Now again equate it. M to the power C3 plus 1 L to the power A3 plus B3 plus minus C3 plus 1 and T to the power we have minus B3 and minus 2. So write the thing, write the statement. C3 plus 1 is equal to 0, that means T3 is equal to minus 1. First formula, C3 is equal to minus 1. Okay, next one, minus B3 equal to, so that means B3 will be equal to minus 2. B3 we got minus 2. Now next one, A3 plus B3 plus minus A3 plus B3 minus 3C3 plus 1 equal to 0. Now A3 we have C3 we got, so A3 minus 2 minus 3 into minus 1 plus 1 equal to 0. So A3 will be equal to plus 2 minus 1 minus 3. So that is nothing but 2 minus 4. It is nothing but minus 2. So A3 we got minus 2. Now put it here. Pi 3 is equal to kya ho jayega? Pi 3 equal to D minus 2 V minus 2 after that rho minus 1 with that F. So pi 3 will be equal to F upon rho V D square. So pi 3 is equal to F upon rho V D square. So now look at here. F upon rho V D square. So you all guys are knowing F equal to rho A V square. Aapne formula padha hoga in an impact of jet. In an impact of jet. This formula I can also write as rho into pi by 4 into D square into V square. This pi by 4 into D square is nothing but area. So F is nothing but what? Pi by 4. That is a constant only. Rho D square into V square. So again, this something which you got, this is related to this formula. This is related to this formula. So as I told you, for every dimensionless number, for every dimensionless number, you will have some formula which is related to that. Koi na koi formula related to rahega hi. Aur agar related nahi hai, fir bhi, the dimension which you are getting, that will be not there. The dimension which you are getting, that will be zero. It's a dimensionless number which you are getting. So you got pi 1, you got pi 2, you got pi 3. You got all this pi 1, pi 2, pi 2, pi 3. Now again I am telling you, number of pi term, how many number of pi term will be there, that is decided in the first attempt itself, in the first step itself, that is by doing n minus m, you got that how many number of pi term.
In that, now pi 1, pi 2, pi 3, in a gate type of exam, they will ask you either pi 1, pi 2, pi 3, किसी एक चीज को निकालने बोलेंगे. But in ESC exam, they can ask you for all these three pi term. All these three pi term. Again, I'm repeating, if you are changing the repeating variable, if you are changing the repeating variable, and still you are maintaining that rule of follow कर रहे हो, so in that case, you will have a different repeating variable. For that different repeating variable, your pi term can be different also. So remember that point. Now, if you have any doubt in the Buckingham Pi theory, in the Buckingham Pi method, in the method of repeating variable method, kuch bhi doubt, kaisa bhi doubt, you can ask me now. आशीष मौर्या, आप बुला रहे हो क्या आशीष मौर्या मेरे को पढ़ाने के लिए? Is it clear? किसमें पावर ऑफ एल इज रॉन्ग है आशीष? किस वाले में पावर ऑफ एल इज रॉन्ग? यू कैन टेल मी, मे बी आई हैव डन सम पाप. अगर कहीं मैंने पाप किया है तो बताइए. Where I have done the power of L is wrong. I'm asking to you, Ashish Singh. Aman, मैंने आपको स्टार्टिंग में बता दिया था नंबर ऑफ पाई टर्म. आप लोग इसलिए पूरा फोकस नहीं करते हो. इन स्टार्टिंग इट सेल्फ आई टोल्ड यू नंबर ऑफ पाई टर्म इज वॉट एन माइनस एम सिक्स माइनस सिक्स टोटल नंबर ऑफ थ्री पाई टर्म विल बी देयर पाई वन पाई टू पाई थ्री. इसलिए मैंने तीन निकाला. In a pi 3 part, is it so? A3 plus B3 minus 3C3 plus 1. It's perfectly correct. It's perfectly correct. आशीष आप अपना एक बार फिर से देखिए. It's perfectly correct. चलिए तो आप सब लोगों को समझ में आ गया. Have you guys understood this or not? Have you guys understood this or not? अगर आप लोग को समझ में आ गया देन आई विल गिव यू स्मॉल न्यूमेरिकल. अगर आप लोग को समझ में आ गया देन यू कैन सॉल्व दिस न्यूमेरिकल एंड टेल मी द वैल्यू. Let's see who will give me the right answer. If you all guys have understood what is this method is, then you can tell me what should be the independent non-dimensional group. चलो गिव मी द आंसर फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन. Give me the answer for this question. चलिए जल्दी बताइए सब लोग. In a fluid machine, the relevant parameters are volume flow rate, density, viscosity, bulk modulus, pressure difference, power consumption, rotational speed, characteristic dimension. Using the Buckingham Pi theorem, what should be the number of independent non-dimensional group? So basically, they are asking you number of pi term. बेसिकली दे आर आस्किंग यू नंबर ऑफ पाई टर्म. तो पहले n कैलकुलेट कीजिए, फिर m कैलकुलेट कीजिए, n माइनस m कीजिए एंड गिव मी योर वैल्यू. गिव मी योर वैल्यू. आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू गाइज, दोज हु आर ऑनलाइन राइट नाउ, आई वॉन्ट ऑल ऑफ यू टू गिव योर आंसर. आप सब लोग आंसर दोगे तो अच्छा लगेगा. दैट विल इंडिकेट दैट यू गाइज हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस. Characteristics dimension, Ankit Kumar Yadav, when I was explaining about Reynolds number, I told you what is characteristics length, dimension which characterize the flow. Like in a pipe flow, diameter is the characteristics dimension, because diameter characterize the flow. If you are going to a hardware shop, what you are asking, aap kya bolte ho, bhaiya 2.5 inch ki pipe dena. So that diameter is characterizing that pipe, that is the identification for that pipe. अब ऐसा तो नहीं बोलते ना भैया 10 मीटर वाला पाइप देना, नहीं. यू आर टेलिंग भैया 5 फीट वाला या 5 इंच वाली पाइप 10 मीटर देना. सो यू आर कैरेक्टराइजिंग दैट पार्ट विद दैट द डायमेंशन व्हिच कैरेक्टराइज योर फ्लो. दैट समथिंग वी कॉल एज कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स डायमेंशन. चलो, सो हियर फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल इतना टाइम लगना नहीं चाहिए था दिस क्वेश्चन. दिस क्वेश्चन नीड ओनली 1 मिनट. क्या पैरामीटर है? क्यू. फर्स्ट वन इज क्यू, डेंसिटी, विस्कोसिटी, बल्क मॉडुलस, डेल्टा पी, पावर, रोटेशनल स्पीड एंड लेंथ. सो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. सो एन विल बी 8. एन तो टोटल 8 हो गया. नाउ वी हैव टू सेलेक्ट रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल. वी हैव टू सेलेक्ट रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल. सो 1 रिपीटिंग वेरिएबल शुड बी ए ज्योमेट्रिकल क्राइटेरिया. तो ज्योमेट्रिकल क्राइटेरिया को अगर लोगे तो लेंथ ले सकते हो. यू कैन, सो लेंथ हो गया. इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट काइनेमेटिक क्राइटेरिया, सो यू विल हैव ऑप्शन. यू कैन टेक क्यू एंड यू विल हैव अनदर ऑप्शन ओमेगा. तो क्यू और ओमेगा में आपका जो मन करे. सो आई एम टेकिंग क्यू. सेकेंड हो गया. नाउ थर्ड वन, डायनेमिक फ्लूइड क्राइटेरिया. सो बेस्ड ऑन दैट वी हैव ऑप्शन रो, म्यू, के, ये सारे ऑप्शन आपके पास. So in that case, what I am selecting is rho. So m is equal to 3. So your number of pi term will be equal to what? 8 minus 3, it will be 5. 8 minus 3, it will be 5. Is it clear to all of you? So answer will be what? None of the above. चलो, तो जिन लोग ऑप्शन सी बोल रहे थे, दैट इज रॉन्ग. आंसर विल बी none of the above. चलो, we are going to the next question, dear. Try this one, everyone. Let's see this question. Who will answer this question? Chali, next question is in your hand right now. For low speed flow over a flat plate, one measure of the boundary layer is the resulting thickness, and at a given downstream location, the boundary layer thickness is a function of the free stream velocity that is V, fluid density. So boundary layer thickness matlab you can write as delta is a function of U infinity, rho, mu, and the distance from the leading edge, that is the x. So n is equal to 5. What about m? X, it can be a geometrical criteria. X, U infinity will be a kinematic criteria. In between rho and mu, you can take, so m will be 3. So the number of pi term will be 2. I minus m is nothing but 2. So you all get this value. Ashish is asking, sir, AC is much more tougher than the gate. No. Gate is much more tougher than the ESC. Gate jada tough hai bacha. Gate jada tough hai. Chalo, ab ek cheez aur aapko sikhata hu. Chalo, ek method aur aapko sikhata hu. Chhota sa method hai. Not widely used, but I am telling you. Dimensional matrix method. This method is not widely used, but this method is interesting. That is something that is the reason I am explaining this to you. Matrix nikalne aata hai ki nahi aap logo? You guys are knowing what is matrix and all. Aapka maths ho chuka hai na? I think Chetan sir already taken in YouTube also. Maths hua hai bhaiya. Ab aisa mat bolna sir, maths nahi hua hai. Maths agar nahi hua hai, then I can't help you. This method you can't solve without knowing the funda of matrix. Chalo. So we have F D. First question I'm talking about. F D. उसके बाद क्या क्या था हमारे पास? Mu भी था ना, I think. Mu. After that we have rho. After that we have omega. Anything else we have? और क्या था हमारे पास? After that length also we have ना? D था, D. चलिए, now what you have to do in this part, in F, M is what? 1, L is also 1, T is minus 2. In diameter part, अच्छा, rho v, velocity I think नहीं लिखा ना हमने, yes, here it will be velocity. देखो मैं कैसे लिख रहा हूँ. Now for D, what is the dimension of this? Only L. So in place of L, I am writing 1. What about mu? M equal to 1. L will be minus 1. T will be also minus 1. What about rho? M is 1. L minus 3. T is 0. 0, 0. Omega. Only in T we have minus 1. Other things are 0. Velocity. We have only what? Length and time. So that is L by T. Mass we don't have. So you have this. You have this matrix. What is the rank of this matrix? I'm asking to all of you. Aap sab log batana, what is the rank of this matrix? Ashish, you asked me about tougher. Tougher means the question level in gate is much more higher. The question level of gate is much more higher as compared to ESE. So you asked me about tougher. That is the reason I told you. If you ask me about syllabus, yes, in ESC syllabus is more. But nowadays, almost gate and ESC syllabus, especially for technical part, is almost same. Koi zyada fark nahi hai.
Chalo, tell me the rank of this matrix. The matrix which is formed, I want you guys to tell me the rank of that. So here I'm writing you, for this method, number of pi term will be equal to n minus r, where r is nothing but rank of matrix. So number of pi term is equal to n minus r. Here if you try to find out rank of this matrix, it will be 3 only. Those guys who are not knowing what is rank, the rank is nothing but number of non-zero rows. That's something we call as rank. So here the rank will be 3. N minus r, number of pi term will be 3 only. N is 6. 6 minus 3, the number of pi term will be 3. So this is something we call as dimensional matrix method. Why? Because some of a parameter, some of the parameter like a stress and all. Stress we can measure in MLT unit also, in FLT, force length time unit also. So वहाँ confusion create हो जाता है. That is the reason in this way you can go with the simpler way. So dimensional matrix method is not widely used. It is used only when there is a confusion between FLT system and MLT system. So this is something which you can write, not so important, but maybe they can ask you for 1 mark. That is the reason I have discussed it with you. Now the Rayleigh method. As I told you, I'm not going to discuss about Rayleigh method. Why? Because this method is obsolete, outdated method now. But I will definitely tell you why this Rayleigh method is obsolete. First reason, everyone write down. If the number of variable is more than 4, this method is not suitable. First thing. Second thing. It is not possible to know the number of pi term in the beginning of the method. Unlike to Buckingham pi theorem, Rayleigh method is not giving you number of pi term at the beginning of this method. This two statement I have given to you, why Rayleigh is obsolete, why Rayleigh is outdated. These two statement which why I have given to you, sometimes they can use this statement as a certain reasoning question in ESC exam. That is the reason I have given you Rayleigh method and why this statement I have given to you. Because sometimes they can ask you this question, ask you in a form of assertion reasoning. So us baat ka dhyan rakhiyega and please note it down. Book for FM Civil. In my first lecture itself, I told you about the book detail, Ashish. मैंने book detail आपको बता दिया होगा कौन-कौन सी book आप refer करो. For a college point of view, if you don't want to invest, two books in you can refer DS Kumar or Modi and Seat. You can refer. Only thing is that don't refer RK Bansal. RK Bansal में बहुत सारे typing mistake मैंने देखे हैं. So my session will be that. It's totally my session. If you want, you can refer, no problem. But my session will be that. Don't refer to RK Bansal because I have seen a lot of typing mistake in that. Is that clear? Is that clear? And if you want to see something more beauty of fluid mechanics, you can go in F.M. White or Senjalan Sambala. That book also you can refer. You will find lot of real life example, or example part is very much in a better way it is explaining to you. CSV2 is worst university we have seen. बच्चा आशीष, जब आप अभी तो आपके CSV2 की बिल्डिंग भी है, जब हमने वहां से किया था बीटेक, CSV2 आपका बहुत ही छोटी सी बिल्डिंग में चलता था. अपनी पढ़ाई पे ध्यान दीजिए, यूनिवर्सिटी की चिंता छोड़िए. फोकस ऑन योर स्टडी, अदर थिंग्स विल नॉट मैटर. इज इट क्लियर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? Is it clear to all of you the Rayleigh method, the Buckingham method, the dimensional matrix method? Is it clear to all of you? Yes or no, dear? Is it clear to all of you? Yes or no, dear? ठीक है, चलिए तो आज की क्लास में यही रखते हैं. इन नेक्स्ट क्लास दैट इज टुमारो, we will complete model analysis. So tomorrow your dimensional analysis part will be completed. That is tomorrow classes, model analysis class. And those guys who have not watched the workout session, especially those guys who are watching my lecture in YouTube, unko to dekhna hi hai, and you have to solve this, because problems aapko kai sare nahi milenge, you will get some new points also. So please go and watch it today. Tomorrow I will ask you, and right now those people who are live, सारे लोगों से पूछूंगा मैं, और सब लोग को वो चीज देखना है. And you have to give me, sir, मजा आया नहीं, because I am selecting question, बहुत ही time लेता हूं उस पर. That is the reason I am asking to you कि आपको वो question मजा आया कि नहीं solve करने में. So go and watch the yesterday workout session, and then again we'll meet. For link, you can go to the description part. Go in my profile section of Unacademy profile, you will find all the free special classes. So aapko description section mein you will get the profile link of mine, so you will get that all the detail in that. So with that guys, thank you so much. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Maja aaya nahi batao? Abhi humne dimensional analysis ka first part complete kiya. We have completed the first part of dimensional analysis. Now the second part is much more interesting. When Reynolds number will come, Froude number will come, aur jyada interesting hoga aapke liye. So maja aaya hai nahi aaya, whether you guys enjoyed or not, whether you guys have enjoyed this or not, I am asking to all of you dear, kya aap sab log ne enjoy kiya ya nahi kiya? Yes Ketan, I am also from CSV2. I passed it from SSIPMT Raipur. Main se Shankara Raipur se pass out hu BTech. It's not BTech, it's B. आशीष, मॉक टेस्ट कहां से मिलेगा? मैंने आपको बता दिया डियर, द वर्कआउट सेशन. आप इस वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन सेक्शन में जाइए, मेरी अनअकैडमी की प्रोफाइल लिंक मिलेगी, उस पर क्लिक कीजिए. उसमें आप फ्री स्पेशल क्लास वाले सेक्शन में जाइए, आपको सारे जितने भी मैंने वर्कआउट सेशन लिए आज तक फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स के, एनवायरमेंट इंजीनियरिंग के, OCF के, आपको सब मिल जाएंगे. यू विल गेट ऑल द डिटेल. ठीक है, चलिए. सो विद दैट गाइस, बाय बाय, टेक केयर, लव यू ऑल, विल मीट अगेन टुमारो शार्पली एट 8 AM.